Hello friends and welcome back to Bitfumes. In this episode, we are going to work on the notification system in Laravel. So for that, you have to go to Laravel docs and just search for notifications. And here we have notifications. And in the intro part, you will get the intro of the notification, but let's get on the work directly. So what we have to do, we have to create a new project for our notification system. So let's just create that project. So let's open terminal here, and I'm on terminals. Let's say Laravel new notification, and it will create a new project. Obviously, you know that. So wait for this. It is completed. So let's start server. So PHP artisan, but before PHP artisan, we have to go into this directory. So notification cd and then PHP artisan serve, and it's started the server. So let's say notification, no, not notification, localhost colon 8000, and here we have the project. So that's great. The notification is sent to a user, so obviously we need a user, and migration will help us here. So let's create a new terminal here, and now I will say PHP artisan migrate. I have to migrate creating tables because we have created the project. So let's open this project in our Sublime. So Sublime is here, and if I go to this database, then migration, then you can see Laravel gives out of the box two migration. So for password reset and user table. So we need user table. That's very nice. So let's create that. But before that, we have to configure our .env file to connect to database. So let's just connect to database. Let's say notify the database name. Then it will be root, and password is nothing. That's good. So let's go to SQL Pro and create a new database called notify. Notify is good. Then it is created. Let's go to terminal and just hit enter PHP artisan migrate. And yes, it is now successfully migrated. So we have this user here. That's nice. We have to create a user or register a user. So next task is to create PHP artisan make auth, and it will create authentication scaffolding. So let's go to Chrome. And if I refresh, you will see login and register button right here. So let's register ourselves. So Sarthak, and details are already filled. So let's give password 123456. And we are successfully registered, but we have to restart our server, as my always problem is this. So let's just restart it. So once more, that's nice. And if I give a refresh, and boom, everything is correctly working. That's great. This means we must have a user. That's good. So obviously we are working on a notification, so we have to create a notification. New notification is created by this command, make notification. So let's just copy this notification, go to terminal on this tab, and just paste this, and notification name, let's say task complete, simple, completed, task completed or complete, it doesn't matter. Okay, so it is good, and notification is created, but where this notification stay in our Laravel project. So if I go to Sublime, go to app folder, here we have new folder notifications, and our task completed notification is here. So you can see it is extending this notification class, and it can use a trait of queueable. That means if I want, or we want to make this queueable, because notification can be mailed, it can be databased also, and there are other options. But if you are using email, then email takes time, and obviously we will cover this queue system. So let's just complete this. So you don't have to do anything else. Notification is completely set up on your system. So let's see what the next task we have to do. So to send a notification, we have to use this thing. So let's just go to, again, Sublime. I will go to web.php file, and here this instead of returning this view, what I'm going to say, I'm going to firstly get the user. So user find with ID of 1, obviously ID will be 1. Then I will say notify, then inside this new task completed. Okay, that's it. You don't have to do anything, just import these things at the top. So I'm using PHP companion, so that's why I have to use this. I will say use, no, use only. So that's good. So you can see it's not doing that thing because my notification name is tasked, not task. So let's just make it correct. So rename this one. So that's task completed. That's nice. And now let's import this at the top. So which is here, obviously the user model, import it at the top. So here we have, so everything is set up. So let's just go to Chrome and go to home page. It will try to send email. It will fail because we have not set up our email configuration. So if I open .env file, you can see our email configuration. Where is that? Yeah, email configuration is not set up. So let's just go to mail trap. That should be trap, yeah, mailtrap.com. It's very .io. It's a very good website because it can trap all the emails. So you can just test literally the emails sent from your project. So that's good. So let's just grab these credentials and don't try to copy these credentials because I will change it later after this episode. So let's go password. That's nice. And it doesn't matter, we can say TLS or not. That's good. Mailtrap is set up. So obviously as usual we have to restart our server. So server is restarted. So let's go to Chrome once more and refresh this page and let's just wait for some time. It will try to send email to our Mailtrap and it is successfully done. So if I go to Mailtrap, we have task completed email and whatever you can give on this email will reflect here. So where this is configurable, so if I go to task complete notification, you can see via email we want to send it via email and to mail. That means what we are going to email these things. So if I change this, it's like Bitfumes. Oh, that should be Bitfumes. Yeah, Bitfumes. And now go to Chrome, reload this. We must see a new email with the button saying Bitfumes. So here we have the new one and yes, Bitfumes is here. One thing more, if you go to this documentation, you can also send this notification by using this facade. We are using here the simple function, but we can also use facade. So let's just grab this and go here. Instead of this all these things, let's just paste it. And I don't want to pass anything. Then my task completed and no, yeah, the user. So let's just say users is equal to user :: find with the ID of 1. And this system, this notification of notification sending by facade is useful when you want to send to multiple users. You can see it's users, not user. So that's good. And let's go here, refresh this page, and we are expecting new email on our Mailtrap inbox. And yes, we are having this, and you can see exactly the same, but very useful. So this is all about notification, not all about. In the next episode we will see more depth concepts of notifications. So till then, don't forget to subscribe, and if you have any problem, feel free to message me, comment me. You can also message me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. So we will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.